evening visitors. Welcome to the Australian War Memorial's Last Post Ceremony. My name is Joanne Smedley, and joining us today from the Australian Army is Lieutenant Colonel Paul Murphy. We warmly welcome the family of Pilot Officer George Victor Weeks, whose story will be told shortly. We welcome the veterans who have served, those that are still serving, and the families that support them. We acknowledge the members of RSL and Services Clubs Association, RSL Victoria and RSL Queensland, who are watching the broadcast of this ceremony across Australia. During this evening's ceremony, wreaths will be laid at the base of the pool of reflection by family, visitors and students on behalf of the following schools. From South Australia, Echunga Primary School, Echunga. From Victoria, Dramana Primary School, Dramana, and Murchison Primary School, Murchison. Please stand and join in the singing of the national anthem. The vision of Charles Bean, Australia's First World War official historian. Bean landed with the Australian troops on Gallipoli and stayed with them at the front through to the end of the war. The idea of this national memorial and museum came to him at Pozières, France, in the depths of the bloody fighting of 1916. Bean's idea was that this would be a place where families and friends could mourn loved ones buried in faraway places. It would also be a place that could help all Australians understand what these men and women had endured and what they had done for us. Bean's vision, to which we remain true, is best expressed as inscribed in the entrance to the memorial's galleries. Here is their spirit in the heart of the land they loved, and here we guard the record which they themselves made. Tonight we will read the story behind just one of those on the Roll of Honour, which lists the names of more than 102,000 men and women who have given their lives for us in war and operations for more than a century. But first we present a lament, Flowers of the Forest. Wreaths of floral tributes will now be laid at the base of the pool of reflection. Thank you.
Today we remember and pay tribute to Pilot Officer George Victor Weeks. George Victor Weeks was born on the 10th of September 1914 in Ballarat, Victoria. The second youngest of six children born to Daniel and Priscilla Weeks. George was the first member of his family born in Australia. His family had recently migrated from the United Kingdom, where his father had served in the military. His father, Daniel, who had served in the 1st Battalion Royal Fusiliers of the British Army, was awarded the Tibet Medal for his service in that area in 1903 to 1904. George Weeks grew up in Ballarat and later moved to Sydney, where he lived and worked as a bank clerk. At the time of the outbreak of the Second World War, he was working as a bank clerk at the Commonwealth Bank in Tamora, in the Riverina area of New South Wales. In August 1937, Weeks travelled from Sydney to Ballarat, where he married his sweetheart, Nancy May Quanshi. The couple would have one child together, Annette, in August of 1940. Weeks enlisted in the Royal Australian Air Force on 24th of April 1942. All five of the Weeks brothers served for Australia in the Second World War. Frank in the Air Force, John in the Army, Ern in the Navy, and Daniel in an Army militia unit. In doing so, they were following in the footsteps of their father, who had served in the Army after migrating to Australia, and during the First World War was wounded on Gallipoli before serving on the Western Front. After joining the Air Force in 1942, George Weeks commenced his training at various bases across Australia, including Air Observer School at Cootamundra, New South Wales, and Bombing and Air Gunnery School at West Sale, Victoria. In February 1943, he sailed from Sydney for Canada to continue his training as part of the Empire Air Training Scheme. This was a system in which airmen from across the British Empire were brought together to train and then sent to serve in units that required their services. In June 1943, Weeks was attached to the Royal Air Force and sailed from Canada for England. In May 1944, he was posted to number 172 Squadron, Royal Air Force. This unit served in Coastal Command, a branch of the Air Force responsible for patrolling the waters of the Atlantic Ocean in search of enemy ships and U-boats. This was a difficult task, and the men of Coastal Command flew long, arduous missions in often appalling weather conditions. In the early hours of the 14th of November, 1944, Weeks took off in a Wellington aircraft from No. 172 Squadron's base, Limavady, Northern Ireland, as part of a routine patrol flight over the waters of the North Atlantic. Shortly after takeoff, Weeks' aircraft burst into flames and crashed into the sea near Malin Head. While the exact cause of the crash could not be determined, the most likely causes were enemy attack or engine failure. Survived by his young wife and four-year-old daughter, Weeks was 30 years old. Weeks was the only member of the crew whose body was ever found. Today, his remains lie in the Drummondchurst Church of Ireland Cemetery in Londonderry, Northern Ireland, under the epitaph, "To live in hearts will leave behind is not to die." His name is listed on the Roll of Honour on my left, among almost 40,000 Australians who died while serving in the Second World War. His photograph is displayed by the Pool of Reflection. This is but one of many stories of service and sacrifice told here at the Australian War Memorial. We now remember Pilot Officer George Victor Weeks, who gave his life for us, for our freedoms, and in the hope of a better world.
Please stand.
They shall grow not old, as we who are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Lest we forget.
Lest we forget. We leave you this evening with the words of the memorial's founder, Charles Bean. Many a man lying out there at Pozieres or in the low scrub at Gallipoli with his poor, tired senses barely working through the fever of his brain has thought in his last moments, well, it's over. But in Australia, they will be proud of this. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, that concludes the last post ceremony. We thank you for visiting the Australian War Memorial and wish you all a very good evening.